I'm meteorologist Carley Gomez with your weather impact alert. We are seeing more triple-digit heat remaining in the forecast, but a cooling trend that arrives next week. Let's take a look at our weather impact alert days. That is one more day for you with a heat advisory in effect through Friday night. We'll be looking at temperatures up to about 108 degrees across the valley. Most spots should be anywhere from 100 to 105, but we could see some temperatures pushing 108. An elevated fire concern is still in the forecast, especially as we move on for the high Sierra spots and even foothill spots into our Friday and Saturday. Wind speeds are expected to also pick up with some Sierra thunderstorm chances. Now, the chances for thunderstorms at this point in time is only about a 10 to 15% chance, but it's a chance nonetheless, and something that could take off quickly, especially as we're looking at strong wind gusts over that Sierra crest. Now, a heat advisory for us is in effect until 8 p.m. We will expect to see a lot of that heat spanning from Redding all the way down to the Grapevine, with excessive heat watches and warnings into Southern California. So extreme heat across most of the state. Lucky for us, we will see this coming to an end by Friday night. The bad news is, a lot of people are out and about Friday night, especially for Friday night football. Temperatures around kickoff, we're looking at 97 degrees. Now, the heat risk this week still major for our Friday. The Sacramento area still getting contributions here from the Delta breeze. They're still going to see temperatures around 102. Unfortunately, other sites closer to 104, 105. We'll see moderate heat for ourselves this weekend, Saturday and Sunday. But that gradual cool down will be in place, mid to low 90s, 95 degrees by Monday, and then finally 80s start returning on Tuesday. Looking at our potential for thunderstorms, we're seeing mostly the areas right from the higher foothills and into the Sierra, over the Sierra crest into Nevada. And again, that's just about a 10 to 15% chance at this point in time. But again, wind speeds are expected to pick up. We are seeing significant fire potential. Just take a look at that map here. You can see a lot of that potential for fire risk in that red zone is high. And that is because you're looking at lightning in the brown spot there. That's moderate and dry conditions there. So still significant fire potential there is moderate, but only one sliver there is going to be low. Very small chance there to see any fire outbreaks. Of course, most of the Northern California region is looking at that potential for fire outbreaks due to all the heat we've been seeing. Now, let's look at the wind gusts, because this will be a contributing factor to whether or not we see a spark spreading quickly. The normal Delta breeze is expected into the evening hours. About 15 to 20 mile per hour wind gusts could be felt around 5 p.m. on Friday. So nice little cool breeze for us, especially as we get out and about Friday night football. Over the crest there, not too bad, but just take a look at this. As we start moving into Saturday, winds really begin picking up, especially south of US 50 and into the Yosemite area. We could expect to see stronger wind gusts there and the potential for fire outbreaks, as those gusts could even get as high as 45 miles per hour. Things should start slowing down by Sunday. Now, what we're seeing with that and the wind speed pickup is the fact that we'll be looking at this, a trough beginning to enter our area as we start moving in from Saturday to Sunday, dropping temperatures into the lower 90s. In the meantime, the high pressure is still in place from Thursday to Friday. Of course, the heat advisory also in place as that high weakens. That'll shift to the east, and then we'll be looking at that trough and that low pressure system arriving for us as we start off the work week. Take a look at Saturday. A few clouds in and out, but nothing major. Just starting the trend of cooling, mid-90s and low 90s by Sunday. And then finally, we do have a very slight chance next week to maybe see this. Yep, that's a chance for some shower activity. At this point, still pretty small chance, but it's one that we'll consider, especially as we move into next week and we could see a low pressure system approaching. If it does dig this far south into California, that could provide us with some areas of showers. But on the opposite end of that, that means we could also see potential for thunderstorm chances. We have a lot of cool air now meeting warm air, and that sometimes causes those outbreaks to occur, especially in those foothill spots. Moving toward the end of next week and next weekend, we'll be looking at more clear skies and the chances to see cool weather in the 80s returning. Lower foothills looking at triple digits expected for tomorrow. If you have plans to head to the Bay Area for the weekend, you're looking at mid-70s, maybe low 80s into Oakland, but 102, 100, Rio Vista, Vacaville, still pretty hot for those zones and into the valley. Again, we could see temperatures warming as high as 108, but some areas mostly 105 to 106 in Yuba City and Colusa, about 102, 103 for a lot of the valley spots down into the San Joaquin Valley. Our three-day forecast does bring the temperatures mid to low 90s. Saturday and Sunday, a few clouds start to enter, and then we see temperatures dropping off into next week. Mid-90s turn upper 80s. And notice you see a lot of clouds coming in on Wednesday. That is that chance we mentioned to maybe see some shower activity. We'll have to wait and see. Otherwise, we'll continue with that trend of upper 80s, low 90s through next weekend.